she worth it?
Was dying for?
Will!
Over the years, several movies and TV shows have been made about Robin Hood. Out of all of them, Prince of Thieves is by far my favorite. No disrespect to Errol Flynn or any of the adaptations before it, but Robin Hood Prince of Thieves is just more energetic, more dark, and more involving. Now before I begin my review, let me just say right off the bat, I know that Prince of Thieves is historically inaccurate as hell. I know it's very different from the book, and I know that King Richard's brother, Prince John, does not make an appearance in this movie, nor is his existence even mentioned. Well, here's the thing. Braveheart was historically inaccurate. The Patriot was historically inaccurate. Catch Me If You Can, Titanic, Forrest Gump, Inglourious Basterds, and even parts of Saving Private Ryan and Amadeus were all historically inaccurate. Movies based on history don't have to be historically accurate to be great movies, as long as they're interesting. Often movies have failed to do this, and those ones just end up sucking hard. But not only is Prince of Thieves interesting and a lot of fun, but it managed to make me love Robin Hood at the age of 4 when my father took me to see it in the theater. As far as being true to the book goes, it wasn't terrible, and I'll tell you why. Blade Runner and Jurassic Park were two films that deviated from their respective novels, but I still consider them two of the greatest science fiction films of all time, because the ideas, concepts, and lessons from the books are displayed perfectly within the films. Prince of Thieves did the same thing, straying from the book in parts, but carrying over the concepts and lessons from the book perfectly. This wasn't like Minority Report, The Adjustment Bureau, Next, and The Lost World, where every fundamental element we grew to love was completely butt-fucked. This was actually done well. Now, this film was requested of me about a year ago, after my reviews for Prince of Persia and Robin Hood 2010 were released. A YouTube user named Certicon got all butthurt because I said Prince of Persia was bad and said in my Robin Hood review that Prince of Thieves was my favorite Robin Hood movie. Under normal circumstances, I would have just ignored him, but for 6 months, this fucker just didn't quit. Persistent little shit, and even after I blocked his ass, he made 10 separate accounts just so he could still bitch me out. This fucker just didn't know when to quit, so here I am saying I won't quit either. Now, this one will be slightly shorter than my last couple reviews, so don't expect a really long assessment on this. Certicon, if you're watching this, fuck you. Prepare for an education. This is Robin Hood, Prince of Thieves. My secret side I keep, hid under lock and key. I keep it caged, but I can't control it. Cause if I let him out, tear me up, break me down. Why won't somebody come and save me from this? Make it end. It's hiding in the dark, his teeth are razor sharp. There's no escape for me, it wants my soul, it wants my heart. No one can hear me scream, maybe it's just a dream. Maybe it's inside of me. Part 1, The Story and the Direction. The story begins with Robin Locksley as a prisoner with his friend Peter during the Crusades. They manage to fight off the guards to attempt an escape and free a Moor named Hazim, who knows his way around Jerusalem. They escape the dungeon, only for Peter to be shot in the back with an arrow. As his dying wish, he asks Robin to protect his sister Marion. Peter sacrifices himself so that Robin and Hazim can escape. However, when Robin returns to his homeland, he finds that his father has been killed after falsely being accused of witchcraft, and that the Sheriff of Nottingham and his cousin Guy of Gisborne have taken over his lands and raised everyone's taxes, forcing most of them to go into hiding in Sherwood Forest. Now, in order to restore justice to the land, Robin Hood must train and unite the merry men of Sherwood Forest in an all-out war against the Sheriff of Nottingham, while also maintaining the safety of his beloved maid Marian and keeping the Sheriff from taking the throne away from King Richard the Lionheart, who was away fighting in the Crusades. The story itself is pretty solid, but what makes it interesting, at least to me, is all the tension-filled moments. The film hardly ever lets up and constantly builds on itself. When Robin Hood first encounters Little John and the merry men of Sherwood Forest, they don't immediately like him. In fact, they try to rob him.
Who are you?
John Little, best man of the woods.
Hey, lads!
Well, best man, you lead this rabble?
Yes, I do, mate. And if you tosspots want to travel through Sherwood Forest, it's going to cost you that gold medallion.
This is sacred to me.
It's sacred to us too, matey. That there will feed us for a bloomin' month.
And it's only when Robin Hood bests Little John in a fight that they start to like him.
Seems I've made it past the gate, John Little. Or should I call you Little John?
Hit him, Father! Whoa.
Give me your name first.
Robin of Locksley.
You got balls of solid rock. Come on.
Well, all except for Will Scarlet, but we'll go back to him when we discuss the characters. This movie constantly keeps you on your toes, wondering what will happen next, and thus it's very unpredictable. Oh, and unlike Slumdog Millionaire and Prince of Persia, this film actually has a believable romance. When Marion first encounters Robin in the film, she gives him a low blow. Literally. She despises Robin at the start of this film. She even makes the comment that she only sees him as the spoiled bully who used to burn her hair as a child. Robin may not be that spoiled bully anymore, but over the course of this film, he proves this to her. In the other films, especially the Disney version, Robin and Marion just sort of love each other because they love each other. That's it. Robin really has nothing to prove in those films, but in this one, he not only has something to prove to Marion, but to himself as well. As the film goes on, the romance builds. They discuss Robin's cause of stealing from the rich and giving to the poor. They discuss their lives. They discuss their feelings. And more importantly, their conversations actually go somewhere in the film and do end up affecting each other in one way or another. That is what a romance is.
You twit!
Now, as I said earlier, Prince John isn't in this movie, thus making it historically inaccurate and taking away one of the main villains of the book. I loved that they did this, and here's why. Prince John is a bitch.
That's right, I said it, who wants some? Come on!
Even in the book and all the other film adaptations, the Sheriff of Nottingham was always more interesting.
A story I tell of an old guy on a bench, he's crying, and I come along, and I said, "What's the matter, old-timer?" Well, he said, "I've just been married 3 months to this beautiful girl. She's 34 years old, and said she just loves me, tears my clothes off and sucks my cock and just makes love to me. And when I come home, she just rips me clothes off and throws me right in bed and fucks me and everything." And I said, "Well, what are you crying about?" He said, "I can't remember where I live."
I mean, even Disney poked fun at this fact.
No. You broke your mother's mirror. Oh, mommy. I've got a dirty thumb.
Prince John was never an interesting character, at least not to me. His plan was always to be declared king while his brother was away. It didn't bother me that they gave this plot thread to the Sheriff of Nottingham, because he was always the better villain. And it even raises more of a conflict for Robin Hood and the Sheriff, because for the Sheriff to obtain the throne in King Richard's absence, he has to marry a woman of royal blood. In other words, Marion. And let's just say for the hell of it, Prince John was an interesting villain. I would rather have him left out than have him be fucked up. You know, like that crappy Ridley Scott version. Fuck that movie. King John my ass. Director Kevin Reynolds did a good job here, which in a way does annoy me. Because while he did direct my favorite Robin Hood movie, he later went on to direct Kevin Costner's worst movie, Waterworld, which is quite honestly one of the dumbest films I've ever seen in my life. It was just terrible. It kind of reminds me of how Mark Steven Johnson kicked ass with Daredevil and then went on to buttfuck Ghost Rider, or how Steven Spielberg kicked ass with Jurassic Park and then went on to buttfuck The Lost World. No director is perfect, but Waterworld, Ghost Rider, and Lost World are pretty unforgivable movies in my opinion. However, I can't take away a thing from Reynolds here. He shot this movie beautifully. The action scenes, especially the fight in Sherwood Forest towards the end, were just epic. Flaming arrows, sword fights, hand-to-hand combat. This was a very dark and realistic film. I also like the wardrobe decisions. These people actually dress how people would have dressed back then. I'm sorry, the ring tights just don't do it for me.
We may look like pansies, but don't get us wrong or else we'll put out your lights. We're men in tights,
tights,
tights. Always on guard, defending the people's rights. When you're in the fix, just call for the men in tights. We're bunch.
Okay, that version never gets old.
We're men in tights. Always on guard, defending the people's rights.
La 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 la.